I'm Yoon Sul, and I've been the Berrics photographer for, as of today, 10 years. I got this job over a turkey bacon sandwich at Quiznos with Steve Barra. I look outside and I see Barra walking by, and he sees me and he does the whole, comes in and he's like, "What are you doing here?" I'm like, "I'm eating lunch. So you mind if I join you?" I'm like, "Sure." He basically said, "Hey, don't bother calling. Just come by anytime you want." And so I really took that seriously and just never called and just came by anytime I wanted. And sure enough, the place became my second home. It's a great place to warm up with the dudes I'm meeting before we hit the streets. And so coming here so many times, you know, and getting to know everyone from the skaters to Barra to the guys that work at the Berrics, they needed a photographer, and you know, I was the first one I think they called because it's just such a regular here. Oh, you know what? Actually, the first day I started was Cliche United Nations. And that was actually really fun. Just the weekend with the Cliche team, and during the Cliche United Nations, Al and Jeremy wanted to shoot an ad with Brophy testing out one of their new boards. And we had this stack of boards, shit you know, it was like the size of Daniel Castillo. And they were saying like, "Yeah, Brophy's gonna ollie with our new board. It's got like new technology that makes him ollie higher." I guess the technology really worked because dude ollied over a stack of boards the height of Daniel Castillo. It was insane. It was cool because I really got to know those guys. I hadn't really met any of the Cliche dudes, and it's pretty much the whole story of being here at the Berrics. It's not only about shooting photos of these amazing people, it's growing relationships with these guys and getting to know them. And you know, all you got to see were these guys on video. You never really got to see them in person. And working here, it's just they all come here and you spend days upon hours upon months with these guys and really get to know these guys. And I think that's really the coolest part of working here. My favorite photos are just my favorite skaters, from like the Reynolds to Heath Kerchart to Guy Mariano to any one of my favorite skaters. They also bring back really fond memories of like good times here, really good times. I remember when we first moved into the new park, we filmed our first Battle Commander with Jamie Thomas, and that was, every moment was pretty interesting in that one. I mean, it was just Chase, Jamie Thomas, and myself. But he also brought in a lot of, I mean, like, dude, he brought in Christian Asoy. That photo is pretty rad. The wall ride from quarter pipe to quarter pipe was pretty gnarly. Muska, I think any photo you get with Chad Muska is pretty epic. Gnarly-wise, I remember Andrew Lange. That blew my mind. I still am in shock of that. He did up the quarter pipe to wall ride to 5-0 stall on just a little beam that was sticking out of the wall, with like 4 feet clearance, and he's a tall guy. I still, to this day, don't know how I did that. Recently, there have been some pretty gnarly ones. Yoshi Tenenbaum, everything he did into that bank. Brandon Burley, that was pretty gnarly. Jimmy Carlin, that was interesting. I mean, him bringing a dude without a shirt on, with suspenders, with a saxophone, in a dark warehouse with very romantic lighting. That was interesting. These two kids ran away from Chicago, and we hear a knock at the gate. You know, it's like, "Yeah?" I'm like, "Hey, can we come in?" And like, it took a second, and I realized, holy shit, you're the kids that have been missing. Like, "Yeah, we ran away from home. We hopped on freight trains and kind of got lost, but we figured out our way." They come on in, and they're in the place they've always wanted to go to. This is their Mecca. And what's inside their Mecca? One of the greatest performances ever seen by Paul Rodriguez, Tori Pudwill, and Shane O'Neill. They're just skating the seventh stair, like trick after trick, trick after trick, trick after trick. And it's just kind of like the lesson wasn't learned. They ran away from home. They got to go inside, a place they've always wanted to go inside. And they were presented with the best demo from three of the best skaters in the world. Oh, we brought in Kyrie Irving, one of the best NBA players at the time and still probably today. He said he could skate, but when I saw him on the skateboard, it was kind of iffy for me. And he said he wanted to do a first try Friday, dropping in on a quarter pipe. And then as we started filming, I just started thinking, holy shit, this guy gets hurt, we're so screwed, we're so screwed. And he did it, first try. NBA player that really didn't look like he could skate, to be honest. During my first couple of years here, Chase, I think, was like, he had a hidden pyromania kind of vibe going on. Any kind of reason he could use fireworks, he would, and like would nearly burn down the park. Ronnie Krieger, Freddy Krueger, the Halloween photo was pretty epic that I loved. Another one of those Chase almost burns down the park with fire. You know, leaving the Berrics was really cool too. There were a couple trips that were very, I still remember. I mean, I remember going to New York with the Mountain Dew team. That was spending like 3 weeks out there with them. That was pretty crazy. Going to Nicaragua with DVS, that was definitely one of my favorite moments working here. Oh, you know, the flat ground photos, flat ground series I shot, that was something I really enjoyed doing here. You know, they say style is everything. That's just kind of pinpoints it to one photo and just shows you how unique and different one trick can look. Another epic thing I just kind of remembered was Tony Hawk. That was pretty epic. I know I got to shoot him at 51, but I think that's even cooler because that was a 51-year-old man who ollied the big four. So if anyone asks if you ever shot any photos of Tony Hawk, which has been asked many times, pretty much any time I tell them what I do, yeah, I did. The Berrics, as much as you want to say it or not want to say it, is a part of skateboarding history. A lot has gone down here, and there's a story of a lot of ups and downs in just this one little piece of skateboarding. And you know, I'm a big fan of documentaries and just kind of always wanted something like that, you know, I want my photos to tell a story. After 10 years and going through these photos, that's what I felt, and I hope like one day when there's a story to be told about this place, it'll be my photos that tell it.